What is your most successful hoof supplement? Ooh.
Yeah, so is Sue here tonight? Sue's in the back, okay. I wasn't sure what successful meant. It could mean best-selling, which I have answers for that. And I'm not sure which is first, second, third, so I'll just give you the top three in any order. And it's Farius Formula Double Strength, and it's our Smart Hoof Ultra, and our Smart Hoof. So those are our three best-selling. I said maybe this by successful, she meant reviews. Mm-hmm. And those all have really good reviews, like 4.8 out of 5 stars and 4.6, and like 98% would refer it to a friend, you know, recommend it to a friend. So that was, to me, that's success.
Yep.
But then me being the veterinarian and scientist, I said, maybe she meant research.
Mm.
Did you mean research? You meant research, right? So I found the research for you. And it's a lot of it is in Lipizzans. And it's really fun statements like, where's a good one here? After, this was 19 months of biotin treatment. It takes a long time for hooves to show improvement. The horn quality showed a small but significant improvement. And in research, the word significant is what you're looking for. When the trend is significant, then you've really done something. Let's see, here's a biotin with a daily dose of 20 milligrams. Improves and maintains hoof horn quality in horses with a less than optimum quality hoof. So I've got one, two, three, four, about five research articles here that all say about the same thing, that biotin improves the hoof hardness, integrity, the quality of the hoof. Now, it's not just biotin. Some of these studies also used formulas that had, say, methionine and lysine and threonine, so the top three essential amino acids or limiting amino acids. They also used the micro minerals, copper and zinc. Some had omega-3s, and collagen is another ingredient you might see in a hoof supplement. So between the best-selling and the reviews and the research, I think I have quantified success for you. So did I leave out anything?
I think you nailed it.
Oh, all right, okay.
So based on that, it seems like looking for a supplement with some nice biotin quality to it, as long as some of those other ingredients. Like
the study said 10 to 30 milligrams of biotin a day, depending on body weight, not less than 6 to 9 months, shows a progress in hardness, integrity, and conformation of hoof horn in all cases. So 10 to 20 milligrams per day. And those three supplements that I mentioned fit that. And I think actually the Smart Hoof Ultra was 35 milligrams of biotin a day. So
you did touch base on a little bit here as far as the number of months for a hoof supplement.
Right.
Can you talk about why it was like 19 months?
I can, yes, because hooves grow very slowly from the coronary band where the hair is down about a quarter of an inch a month. So if you think about the average horse's hoof being 3 inches long, it takes a year for a hoof to grow fully out. So most of these studies were at least 1 year in length. And in fact, one of them said several months after they stopped giving the biotin, the new growth was poor quality again. Mm. So that's a really good study because it said it was poor quality, and then we gave the hoof supplement and it got better, and then we stopped giving it and it got worse again. So,
which is so interesting. I think a lot of people always start looking at the toes to see if there's cracking. You have to start.
You
got to
look
the
where
top.
The hair comes out. It's just like your fingernails. You know, the stuff out here is dead, but near the skin, the cuticle is where it's live. Yeah.